Hello and welcome to this Grunt tutorial where we shall be going over the Sass plugin. More specifically, we're going to be figuring out how to auto-compile Sass files into normal CSS files. In later tutorials, we're going to be going over the watch feature so we can do this automatically without having to run the Sass command every 2 minutes. But yeah, nevertheless, let's go ahead and install Sass. Sudo npm install grunt-contrib-sass. Save dev, sudo npm, that should work. Okay, now Sass is installed. What we want to do is go into our Gruntfile, load the plugin, well, the task, whatever you want to call it. Now we've done that, we can, let's have a look where we are. We've installed the task, we can start adding Sass. Just put Sass there. Let me create a new folder in here. Sass. Next. Let's just make sure we've got a style. Let me add some Sass in here. I'm just taking this from the website, the Sass website, just to show you how it auto compiles. Let's have a look. So we've got our Sass file, which is actually in CSS main, so I'll get rid of that. What we want to do is create a new file in here, just for example's sake. Call that style dot Sass. Should we call this style dot scss even? So yeah, let's go ahead and we've got our Sass file. What we ideally want to do is we're going to compile this particular Sass file into here. So, and we can also do it in the future. So, this particular Sass file compiles into here. Then, once this has been compiled, we can minify the file. So, let's go ahead and add our Sass functionality. So, distribution. Files, we want to do CSS, we've done this before, CSS style.css, Sass style.scss. Make sure we have a comma because we're defining our new package, plugin, task, whatever it may be. And that should work, I guess. We can give that a quick go. What's going to happen is this particular Sass file here is going to just compile into here. As you see, this is empty at the minute, but if we run grunt sass and it's running, done without errors, and there we are, it's compiled the file. As you can see, the difference basically is, so can I pull this off here? I can. Let me just grab this, put that over there. As you can see, so on the right here, our Sass file, and it's compiled it into just regular CSS. So yeah, that's Sass, very simple. There's obviously a lot more functionality that can be added, but for now I'm going to leave the description of the Sass plugin or package, the link to the repository on GitHub in the description below. Go ahead, check that out. Add some additional functionality. But until then, the next video we're going to be going over the watch feature, and I'm going to be showing you how to minify your CSS files upon changes in Sass files. So yeah, and other things as well. The watch feature is probably my favorite throughout the Grunt development package. So yeah, thanks for taking the time to watch this video. And I shall see you in the next one.